Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. So in today's video, we are doing something very different. We're doing a Notion challenge. Now this might be a new series that we release here on the channel. Essentially what I'm gonna be doing is giving myself 5 minutes, which I'll have a timer in a second, that I will have to create a specific Notion tool from scratch. So hopefully in those 5 minutes, I'll be focused on here, working on a certain experience. And then I will explain it in the next 5 minutes and how I went about doing that. So for this first episode of the Notion challenge, I will be setting myself the challenge of creating a budget manager. So this is ideal for if someone is looking to manage their personal expenses or stuff that's coming in and out of their account. So hopefully this video gives you a good idea of what and how you can reduce your spending or even keep track or manage your outgoings and incomings. So let's dive in. I've got 5 minutes. I'm gonna set my timer now. Okay, so my timer has started. Let's go. Ah, Jesus, that scared me. Okay, guys, so I actually don't think I did very well. I tried maybe overextending myself during this, but let me just give you a guided tour of this one and how it can work and how it can be used in everyday practice. So this is the budget manager I've created. Now, the goal of this was so that I could just keep a track on everyday expenses. Maybe you want to sit down at the end of every day and start inputting it. Now, one of the things you can do from scratch is if you already had a setup like this, you could go ahead to the three dots area, the options, and actually merge it with an Excel or a CSV that you already have. But just remember to change the columns based on it. And of course, they'll input directly into what you already have. Now, I'm gonna show you a few things that, I'm gonna show you how it works and then a few ways to customize it to your everyday access. So for example, let's say I went ahead today and I created or bought some groceries. So obviously I would add the title at the expense. What I tried doing here is adding a routine roll up. So for example, I made an everyday items list of like the expense that was going out, but it didn't actually connect the database for some reason. So I'm gonna skip past that entirely and delete that property, but I probably will come back to that in a full budget manager video if I find time. So you can see here the groceries, obviously I'm gonna say I'm gonna spend £25.45 on it. And you can see, obviously, you can go to the currency area and change it to pounds or whatever currency that you're working in. In this case, I'm going to say that type is food. So I'm going to add a type there. And I also added a column for the assigning. So, for example, who actually bought this one? And the main reason I did that is because if you and your family or you and a couple share the bills, then you can see who exactly got it and how much they paid for it. So in this case, I'm gonna say it's just myself and any notes next to it so that you can tally, for example, oh, we could save £2.50 next time or something like that, or use the coupon code during the checkout. So you can see here, I've already got my first entry in here. And one of the things that you can do, let me add a few more and jump back and explain why this is quite cool. Okay, okay, so I've added a few dummy entries and of course you'll be able to add as much as you'd like. As you can see, it's a super simple one, but I wanna explain the viewing option. So one of the many benefits to having the viewing option is that you can go and add a view. And in this case, I'm gonna add a calendar view because if I go ahead and create it, you can see like an entries per day view, which is quite nice. So for example, if I wanted to add another entry, for example, today I bought chocolates, then I could, for example, add that entries there. It was, I think it was £6.50 chocolates. And you can say there it was for birthdays and you can choose who it was from as well. Now, as you can imagine, you can get this sort of tally of what you've got and that's quite nice. And if I skip back to this view, obviously everything will be updated in this view here. So it's quite a nice way of actually being able to see that. And if I wanted to be able to see in a descending order, for example, like the latest ones at the top, then you can use these sorting abilities quite easily. Now, one of the things that you can do is, for example, if you were like, okay, I need to know how much I'm spending on birthdays or on the bills, for example. So for example, if I said and selected the type and contains bills, And what I could do down here is use the calculate button on this area to calculate the sum. For example, I could see, okay, this month I've spent, I've spent £370 on entries. So for example, if I was like, okay, I'm gonna add next month's bill. So maybe you're saying next month's rent. Okay, so what you can do is use the and date is within and the past month as the entry. And you can see here, you can only see the March entries for bills. And that's quite a neat way in using the filters to select, for example, how much you spent on certain things, like for example, food in that month, entertainment or birthdays, for example, in that month. And that's quite a good way forward. So that's a little bit about how to use the filtering abilities. Of course, if I take all the filtering abilities off, I will get a bit of an outline of all of the total costs. And one of the things to waste, if you wanted to get rid of it without the filtering abilities, is you could add a third column, for example, paid for. And you can add it the property type checkbox and scrabble it up here. And every time you've paid for something, you should tick it off. And in this case, you could set up a filter that hides any of the checkboxes that are ticked off. For example, paid for is off. You can see that these aren't paid for and they are upcoming. So this is a good way in being able to tally. And for example, if you wanted to add to that filter, you can go, okay, I wanna see things that are coming up in the next month, for example, are after this date. What's after this date? And actually, that's a bad example. What is after this date and what is coming up? And what do I need to pay for? So this is quite a good way in being able to track what future payments coming out and what past payments are coming out. So guys, that was the Notion challenge. Let me know in the comments whether you liked it or not, whether it helped you to build something quite fast for your Notion account. Of course, you can build pretty much anything. And what I want you guys to do is recommend to me in the comments below what you would like to see in the next Notion challenge. What should I build from scratch? I won't do any research. I'll literally build it in those 5 minutes or 10 minutes if it's a bit more mental, and I'll give it a try. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to hit subscribe. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. Do comment below, and I will see you guys next time for another video all about Notion challenges.